Hello everybody, happy Independence Day to one and all. Today we're going to share with you one of India's unsung heroes, an international medalist and India's very first para rower, Kritika Khanna. Kritika Khanna hails from the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, where she had to face a very tragic accident at a very early age and losing one of her limbs. This did not deter her. She continued to excel at academics, at art and dance, and not want to shy away from a challenge. At the age of 34, she took a plunge into the sport of rowing, leaving her home state for the first time in her life. And she decided to go on to the Asian Rowing Championship. And Kritika, at an age of 34, when most retire or settle down, she started her journey. She decided to try and tame the bull by the horns, and she managed to actually tame it. So listen to her story.
Hi, I'm Kritika Khanna. It's basically an honor, and of course I feel blessed to have represented my country. And I think I feel more like a soldier who's holding a national flag in their hand, and you know, you are in an international land, and there is when you feel so proud of yourself that you are the face of your country at present. So it was an amazing experience of 1.5 years for me actually, because I was training with the army men since a very long time then. I think that 1.5 years span was there. And of course, first of the problem that I faced was actually adjusting to the army culture, because they are acquainted with all the exercises and the routine they follow. Their schedule is very much there since a very long time. And firstly, entering into that schedule was a challenge for me, because you know, at home you're a lazy daisy person, you are attending your office routine and everything, and suddenly the schedule is a complete schedule change to workouts and everything. So of course it was challenging, because yes, taking up rowing was one big challenge for me, because I was a non-swimmer, the very first thing, and getting on the water was a challenge of course. But somehow in the beginning it was very good for me, because I was learning something new, I was adjusting to the new atmosphere. And then came the time when I developed a water phobia, and I think my boat capsized, and I faced one of the biggest major challenges for me was to overcome that fear. And it took me a few months to overcome it, and I took support of my family, my mentors were there who were helping me out, get out of the phobia. But yes, still it is there, but now I feel little happier that somewhere I was able to fight with that support that was around me. As a woman, of course, because I started this sport at the age of 34, and I think at this stage generally the women all around the world, and of course in our society, it is the age when they get married and have kids and everything, and I was a person who was actually deviating from the line and entering into sports. So that was again a big challenge for me, because my office, my family, everybody was like, huh, why do you want to take up this sport, and why, I mean, what is in your mind, and how come you have just, you know, ye kahan se tumhe fatoor aaya? That was the word everybody used, ye fatoor tumhe kahan se aaya? And I was like, this is an honor actually, because I will become an inspiration for the other ladies to come forward, especially being a para rower. It becomes a responsibility of mine to actually become a strength or maybe an idol figure for the other ladies who want to come out of their comfort zone and take up challenges in life. So I think that was a blessing in disguise for me, and going through all those things, all those hardships. Of course, when I was standing and, you know, receiving the medal and holding the Indian flag, I was like, I think everything I faced throughout this journey has brought me to this. So automatically things got better for me, and I felt so proud to having done that. In the very beginning, when I knew nothing about this sport, I think Colonel Gaurav Datta was always there with me, and he was my biggest strength actually, above my family also, because he was always motivating that, you know, you have it in you, you have to try, you just have to give it a shot. So just believe in yourself, you can do it, you're a strong person. I think those small words actually got the strength out of me. I felt like doing something, that if this person is believing in me, I'm sure he has seen something, and I have to live up to those expectations. Of course, I'll not say that he was pressurizing or those kind of expectations, but he always made me realize what my potentials are and what I can do. So he was the biggest support for me. Of course, when I was training in the academy, also in the ARN in Pune, everybody around was always motivating, was always helping. Even if I was facing challenges, sometimes, you know, I had some injuries or maybe I was not able to perform certain exercises. So nobody would ever pressurize or put that stress on me. They would always ask me to take it slowly. You know, you will be able to do it and you will do it for sure. And that thing always gave you amazing strength to proceed forward and take up the sport. Being a new sport, of course, and again, I'm saying being a non-swimmer, you know, pani ko dekh ke darna was a biggest thing for me, because there was a time when I was not able to stand in front of the channel. You know, getting on the boat was one thing, but not even I was able to stand in front of the water. It was that huge. And that's when these people helped me out to come out of it, you know. It is always telling me ki theek hai, you know, you should not feel stressed. It is normal with everybody to develop a phobia. But of course, you have to train yourself. You have to educate yourself. You have to actually bring the person out of yourself, because you can come over it. So that's when Colonel Gaurav Datta helped me a lot. And of course, family support is always there. Without family support, I think I would not even have been able to reach Pune unless they would have supported me and allowed me to go forward with this. So of course, when it comes to mentors and your support system, yes, that is the biggest strength one can have. You know, they always call me this, that I have a keeda in me. This is what they actually quote, that you have a keeda in you. And, you know, if you are going into this field and you want to take up this sport, and everybody was, since the very beginning, they would say, ki, tu to kar legi, tu to kar legi. And I used to be like, I mean, it is not that easy. Ye kehna bahut asaan hai. But being at the ground level and, you know, facing all the hardships throughout. And I think I even when we had to go for our event, I had an ankle injury. And that was a very, very big thing for me, because it was just a week before the event. So somehow it was more like there was a different kind of stress all over me. Throughout the journey, there has been a lot of hardships. But why now? Why at the end minute when we are prepared for something? And why now? But I think that is also when I lost hope also. I was like, maybe I will not be able to go to the event. But again, Colonel was there, my friends were there, and they were like, tu kar legi, you don't worry, you will be there. And I think our Fox also, Rohit was there with us. And Rohit was always the support system, me going to the doctor, coming from there, you know, always keeping me boosted and motivated. So, of course, I had a lot of people around to support me. And that was a blessing, of course, from everyone. I think I really feel blessed to have so many people in my life. Colonel referred me to Abhinav Bindra's physiotherapy center also, where I was provided help, and I think I recovered within few days. I think within a week I was back on the boat and I was training amazingly. So that's again a big thank you to him also, who actually, you know, made the recovery so easy. And it was an amazing experience, because it was the very first time for me also to go into such a center and, you know, get all the treatment from there. And I think kudos to them also. Their team also did a very wonderful job. Uh-huh. And I was again back on water. The very first thing you are supposed to do is believe in yourself. That's the best thing you can do. There might be a lot of hardships. You know, they always say whenever you want to do something, there'll be a lot of obstacles in the way. There'll be a lot of hurdles in the way. But what do runners do? What do athletes do? They always cross the hurdles and reach their goal. So I think you should have the willpower and you should believe in yourself that one day you will reach your goal. You might feel there are a lot of failures. You might face the failures, but of course, face them with the same strength the way you want to reach to your goal. So always do that. Just believe in yourself. I think mentorship and the sport has helped me achieve great results. So Justly is providing mentorship, life skills and sport to the most deserving underprivileged children of the society. So please join as a mentor and train these children and train the coming generation to achieve great success in their life and explore their potential. Thank you.